Query syntax. Method syntax. Mixed syntax. These are the three ways to write a link query. But what does each one mean? How to write a query using these ways? What is easier or better to use? Are these three ways the same or is there a difference between them? What does a lambda expression mean? How to use it exactly? And many other points I will show you in this video. If you want to learn LINQ and you don't know how to start, I recommend you to watch the LINQ playlist on my channel. There are many different videos about LINQ and UiPath. You can find the link in the video description. Let's go. Before start talking about the three ways, let's do a recap about LINQ. What does it mean and what are the requirements for a LINQ query? LINQ is to retrieve data from different sources and formats. So it's to transform a data source to a new form, after doing some calculations or filtering the data. And query is a set of instructions that applied to a data source to perform certain operations. A LINQ query consists of these three parts. Initialization, condition, selection. Initialization is to define the data source, where we get the data from. For example, a data table, an array, string, SQL, XML or any other data source. Condition is to filter the data, to get specific data. Here we can also sort the data, do some calculations or also group the data. And selection is to select the data after doing the steps before. We can select single items, or also a group of items. These are the standard parts, but a query could also contain only two parts. For example, only initialization and condition, or initialization and selection. It depends on the query, what we wanted to using it. But initialization must be available in each query. One last thing about LINQ. LINQ returns an IEnumerable output. What does it mean? It provides a set of static methods for querying objects that implement IEnumerable. It's like a collection of elements. The structure of IEnumerable variable looks like this one. We have outer curly brackets. Within these brackets we have different elements. Each element is also set within curly brackets. For example, the following IEnumerable variable, which contains these numbers. Each number is an element. We can convert this variable to another type using a method. For example, to convert it to array, we can use toArray method. The result is as follows. Or to convert it to data table, we can use copyToDataTable method. So to convert this variable to another type, we need a method. That's all about LINQ for now. Let's now start learning the different ways to write a LINQ query. I will start with the first one, query syntax. It's an easy way to write a complex LINQ query in a readable format. The syntax here are very similar to SQL query. The query looks like this one below. We first have from operator. This represents the initialization of the query. Here we define the data source, where the data comes from. For example, a data table, an array, a string, or something else. The next one is where operator. This represents the condition. So here we set a condition, to filter the data. Or we can also here set an order operator, to sort the data. Or we can add any operators we need, to perform certain operations. In other words, this part is the body of the query, where we set the different steps to transform the data. At the end we have select operator, to select the data we need from the data source. Here we can either select a single element, or also a group of elements. Let's see the following query to understand it better. I have here an array, which contains 5 numbers. It's an integer array. First I defined a variable n. This variable represents the numbers of the array. This line is exactly the same as for each loop. The next line contains a condition. This condition is to check if the number is greater than 3. It means until this point, I want to loop the numbers of the array and check each number if it's greater than 3. At the end I select the number which meet the condition. So the output of this query is the following. As mentioned before, the result of a LINQ query is always of type IEnumerable. Therefore I have curly brackets. In these brackets I have different elements. Each element is also added within curly brackets. Let me explain to you, how does the query work exactly? So we have at the beginning from operator. In this line the variable n has the value 2. We move on to the next line, where operator. Here we check this variable, if it's greater than 3. It's false, therefore we don't move to the next line. It means, we don't select this number. So we go back to the first line. The variable n has now the value 5. Then we check it, if it's greater than 3. 5 is greater than 3, so it's true. In this case, we move on to the next line, select operator. Here we select this number. Now we have the number 5 in the output. Then we go back to the first line and check the next number. And so on, we do the steps for each number in the array. At the end, we will get the following output. This is how the query will be executed. So this is the standard structure of a query using query syntax. We used from, where and select operators. We can also use the following operators using query syntax. Group, join, group join, order, let. Only these operators can be used in a query syntax. To use them, we have to add them between from and select operators. We can also use any operator more than once in the query. It means, we can have more than one where operator in a query, and also more than one select and so on. We have many other operators in LINQ, but they cannot be used in query syntax. For example, sum, take, skip, average, and many other operators. To use these operators, we have to use method syntax. Method syntax is the second way to write a LINQ query. To write a LINQ query using method syntax, we use Lambda expression. What does it mean and how to set it? Let's see. Lambda expression consists of two parts. On the left side, we define a function. For this function, we define a variable name, for example, x. On the right side, we set a predicate using the variable name. For example, where operator will be written as following. This expression means that I want to check each element of the data source if it's greater than 3. Let's see another operator, for example, select. This expression means that I want to select each element from the data source and multiply it by number 5. As you see, I always define a function with a variable. For the variable, we can use any name we want. And after the function, we write an expression. As you see, in both examples, I used only one variable for the function. But some operators have more than one parameter. For example, where operator has also this structure. I have two parameters. The first one is for the source data. The second one is for the index. So here I define two variables, A and B. A represents the elements of the data source. B represents the index of the elements. This is how to write a lambda expression. The function is like for each loop. It's to go through all elements of the sequence. Let's go back to method syntax. The structure of the query looks like this one. I always define the data source at the beginning. Then I use as enumerable function to convert the data source to enumerable type. In this way, I can use LINQ operators. After that, I can set the operators, which I need. For example, I can set where operator to filter the data. And if I need other operators, I can also add them after each other. For example, select operator to select the elements from the data source. As you see, we have first the initialization, then the condition, and at the end the selection. Let's see the following query to understand it better. I have again the same array. Then I used where operator to get only the numbers, which are greater than 3. At the end I used select operator to get these numbers as output, which meet the condition. The output of this query is the following. It's the same output, what I got from the query using query syntax, what I showed you before. So these both queries are the same. Using method syntax, we can use all LINQ operators. So each operator can be used in method syntax. To use any operator, we need to use lambda expression. It means, for each operator, I set the operator. After that, I set a lambda expression. For example, group operator. We set it as following. Order operator as following. Sum operator as following. Max operator as following. And so on for each operator we want to use. This is how to write a query using method syntax. In summary, we write the data source with the function as enumerable. Then we set the operators we need after each other. For each operator we use lambda expression. This is how to use method syntax. Before moving to the next point, let me show you this query using method syntax. I only showed you examples using lambda expression with one variable. In this query I have a lambda expression consisting of two variables, A and B. I will execute the query step by step, so that you can understand, how does a query work, once we have two variables for one operator. As already mentioned, A represents the elements of a sequence, and B represents the index of the elements. The index starts always with 0. It means, the first number in the array has the index 0. The next number has index 1 and so on. I will show you the content of these four parts. the variables a and b, the condition and the result of the condition, and also the output of the query. Let's start step by step. At the beginning we have an array with as enumerable function. After that we have the operator where. The condition here is to check if the numbers of the array are greater than the index of the number plus 2. So we go through all elements of the array. The first element is number 2. In this case the variable a has the value 2, and b has the value 0. It means the index is now 0, because it's the first element in the array. The condition is as follows. 2 is not greater than 2, therefore the condition is false. Therefore we don't select the number 2. We move on to the next number. It's 5 and the index is now 1, because it's the second element in the array. The condition is now true, because 5 is greater than 3. So we select this number. The output has now the number 5. We move on to the next number. The number is now 3 and the index is 2. And so on, we go through all elements of the array one by one. The output of the query is the following. This is how can we set two variables in a lambda expression. As you see, there are some operators, which have more than one structure, like where operator. So we have some operators, which have only one parameter or also more than one. To learn more about each operator, please check the link videos on my channel. I publish some videos about different operators. And I will also publish new videos about the remaining operators. That's all about method syntax. Let's now move on to the third way to write a link query, mixed syntax. Mixed is nothing but query syntax and method syntax at the same time. It means, we use both ways together to write a query. For example, this query here. As you see, I have the same structure as query syntax. From, group, let, select. All operators are used without lambda expression. But I also used operators in the query with lambda expression. For example, the operator sum. Or also operator element at. This operator is used without lambda expression, but it used as extension method. It belongs to method syntax. So I used both query and method syntax. Using this way you can use any operator you need. You have a readable query. And it's easy to understand. So I prefer to use this way to write a query. And I always use this way to write a query, but you can choose the way you are familiar with. It's only a recommendation for you. Let's see another query using mixed syntax. Here I also used other operators with lambda expression. But I still have the query syntax. That's all about this way of writing a link query. So these are the three ways, how to write a link query. In summary, you can use query syntax only if you want to write a simple query, using one of these operators. But if you need to use other operators, like take, skip, sum, max, etc., you have to use either method syntax or mixed syntax. If you want to see more examples about writing a link query, please watch the other link videos on the channel. There are many videos with different examples about different operators. This video is only introduction for writing a link query in different ways. I hope you enjoyed the video and could learn something new. If you still have any questions about this topic, please don't hesitate to write us back. Thanks for watching and have a great day.